Hello and welcome to Sunday Brunch Live. We're not ready, but we'll give it a go. Bear with us. I'm Tim Lovejoy, I know that.
I have croissant in my mouth and I'm Simon.
We're joined this morning by presenters Mollie King and Matt Edmondson, singer Tony Hadley, actor Alex Vlahos, and today's music guest Georgia Smith. Lily Allen will also be joining us a little bit later on, but she was performing at JY at 1:30 this morning, and so we've given her a little bit of a line. You used to do that, didn't you?
Yes, we did.
How was that gig when you did
that? Such a good gig. So much fun. So, yeah, I'm sure she'll.
And then you used to come straight on the show after, didn't you?
We did, yeah.
Without any sleep, yeah. Right, first things this week, Mollie, you've recently become a Radio 1 DJ.
Yes, I have.
Congratulations.
Oh,
have you got your own headphones?
I actually don't, no. None of us do we?
No, they're all shared, and I worry about the hygiene of that sometimes. Coming on to someone else and put the same headphones on.
Yeah, who knows what's going on? No, it's so exciting.
Every time you get there, you go, oh, I've broken headphones. Because when I worked in radio, it was always the same way. It was like,
yes.
Why are all the headphones always broken?
Well, I like to, if there's a mistake that happens, and it often does, just blame it on the headphones. Just say, the headphones are broken again. It's nothing to do with me.
Have you learnt how to drive the desk yet?
That I had my first lesson, actually, this week.
How was that?
Matt is completely in control of that at the moment, thank God. There's just so much going on, but, yeah, I am learning as we go.
It's the technical term for it, Tony.
It's inattentive driving the desk. I was getting a bit confused.
It's like driving
it is very early.
It's like learning to drive a car. At the beginning, it's stressful and you don't know what's going on.
Yeah.
And then eventually it does sort of click.
But you always look so calm. Matt just literally is like chatting away, doing it all. And I'm like, how is he keeping
Matt,
calm?
Do you have that recurring dream where the records, the track's running out and you're trying to fix up the next one? You have that one?
My nightmare dream is that I turn up and no one else is there. The producer's not there. So I have to try and set the studio up and then the records are there, so I just have to talk and talk and talk. Like, I don't know how people do talk radio where they just have nothing to do, because if something goes wrong with us, just press play on a song and it's fine. The song's always there to save you.
And you had a special guest on yesterday on your show.
Yeah.
My daughter.
Yes, we did. Yes, she phoned into the show. I was talking about being on this show. I'm a big Sunday Brunch fan, but I was worried because I'm a very fussy eater. I like food exactly like that. It's a bit beige, right? And I was worried. I was saying, what do I do if they give me food and I'm not sure if I'm going to like it or not? And your daughter phoned the show up and said, listen, I've been there with my dad. He sometimes makes stuff that's brilliant. 95% of the time, it's great. But sometimes he will make something that's a bit of a curveball. And she was saying that the way to get around it is to ask you about Liverpool if I don't want to have to eat it, or to ask you about yourself. So, Simon, how's it going?
Morning, Flo. We'll see you later.
On the show, we call them his drunk recipes.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
Flo's
my tasting panel.
Do you have that thing where you wake up in the middle of the night and you think, I'm going to put this in my notes, this is such a good idea.
Yeah.
And then the next day it's like
tuna with meringue.
Wake up.
Many of those in the kebab shop.
Tuna with meringue.
Someone jot this down. It's in the next cookbook.
We're joined now by radio presenters Matt Edmondson and Mollie King. Mollie.
Yes.
You're now on the radio with Matt.
I know.
How did that happen?
Well, I went in for a month. Do you want to tell this? Because you tell it better, really.
Don't do this to me when they start the radio show. You do this one. I'm off to the vending machine.
Yeah.
You say this. Okay, Tim. So we had some guest hosts on Radio 1. I was like, right, we need to do something on the show on the Saturday to make it more exciting. Let's get some people in. And the first person that we got in was Molly. And the first week she was on, I thought, oh, she's pretty good at this. And then the second week she was on, I thought, she's really good at this. And then by week four, I was like, do we have to have other people come in and do this show? And so we sort of had a chat and said, would you like to come to Radio 1? And Molly said, in a very uncool way, yes, please, 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 yes.
They're like, it's with Matt. I was like, oh, I'll call you back.
And then they said, oh, you're going to do Fridays, Saturdays and Sundays together, which is a kind of a new thing for Radio 1. So,
why are they doing that? Why this three-day weekend?
They've decided that weekends aren't long enough, right?
Yeah, starting it early. Got to get that party started on Saturday, haven't you? Friday, sorry.
Please,
very early
please
for me,
don't tell me. I know you're in the Saturdays, but it's not all about Saturday.
All right? Why
it's
not?
Over. Is it too late? So what time are you on? What time of day are you on?
1 till 4.
1 till 4.
Yes.
Okay. Are you enjoying it? Have you learnt how to do radio yet?
It's honestly so much fun. I think for me, because I've done music for so long, I always thought I'm not going to find anything that I love as much as this. And then I went in and I came away from our first show and I called Mum and I was like, I absolutely loved that. And my mum was like, yeah, you could tell that you were genuinely having a ball. And we just have so much fun, don't we? Mm. We're just constantly taking the mick out of each other. And I've learned that if I tell Matt something, if I don't want it to not go out on the radio, don't tell him. Because if it's an embarrassing story, he loves to put it out there.
That's kind of the key to a good partnership, though, isn't it?
Yes.
And we've got none of those about each other.
you get guests on the show. You had Bryan Cranston on recently, and
yes.
You managed to stitch Molly up with Bryan.
Yes,
he loved this.
So, firstly, I love Bryan Cranston. He's the guy from Breaking Bad. Yeah. I think he's a brilliant actor. And I had this idea of, well, how good an actor is he? Could he pretend that he knows who Molly is, even though he clearly would have no idea who Molly was? So we got him on, and I was able to take him aside from Molly and say, look, she was in this band called The Saturdays. Can you pretend to be a super fan? And he delivered the performance of his life. You fell for it, hook, line, and sinker.
Oh, I really fell for it.
We've got a clip.
Here we go.
Oh, no.
Can you name one other member of The Saturdays?
You're really putting him on the spot
well,
there.
There's Frankie, Rochelle, Una. Is it Victoria or
Vanessa?
Vanessa.
Yes.
Yes.
Do you know why I like Bryan?
Go on.
It's because I believe that he is the greatest actor of his generation. You give him any role, he will absolutely nail it.
Thank you, mate.
Do you know why I think that?
Go on.
Because we just gave him the role of being a Saturday super fan. He's never heard of the Saturdays before.
You're lying.
No.
Oh.
I'm so sorry.
Literally, I was made up. Because at first he was like, oh, I'm a fan of... Because I was like, oh, we're fans of yours. And he said, I'm actually a fan of yours. And I thought, there's no way, absolutely no way. He's got me confused with somebody else. And he was like, you know, I love the music. He was like, I love the production of the songs. That's when I should have thought, really?
This can't be real. We had someone in his ear, so any question we had about the Saturdays, someone was there on the internet feeding it into his ear.
I feel so embarrassed now, because I really
felt you took it really well. I don't think I would have taken it that well.
I think you had to. It's Bryan Cranston, come on.
Yeah. So you're going to get guests every week onto the show?
I think that's the plan.
As many as we can, yeah.
Basically going to try and steal some of the people from this show today. So Georgia, come on the show. Tony, come on. Lily Allen, come on. Yes, we'll have people ideally come onto the show whenever you want. If you're famous and watching this now, please come on our
show. Come and have a chat, yeah.
I can't get you on without talking about Strictly.
Yes.
Are you still on the WhatsApp group?
Of course, yeah. It's so active, the
really
WhatsApp
active.
Group still, isn't
yeah.
it? Yeah. It's pumping on there.
Is everyone on it?
Oh, everyone is on it, yeah. So someone's always got something to say. So you wake up and there's like 10 WhatsApps on there.
Wow.
Oh, and God, just random stuff as well. You know, somebody was suddenly like, Bryan Connolly, for example, suddenly dropped something. You've not spoken to him for like 3 weeks. You know, yeah. Dropped something obscure, normally rude.
Yeah, normally, yeah. It seems like ages ago now, doesn't it? It just feels like a different lifetime. Aww.
You thoroughly enjoyed it though, didn't
I
you?
Absolutely loved it.
Yeah, both of you just had the time of your lives, didn't you?
It's the best thing. And
isn't
I think
it,
now you feel like you're part of the best private members club ever because you do that kind of knowing. Look, if other people have been on other years, then you do that look.
Yeah.
I mean, you'll know after this year.
Oh, yeah, done deal. Matt, you're on it this year.
What, you and me together?
Yeah,
well, great.
I'll teach you how to do it.
Yeah. I was chatting to Simon before about this, and I did a thing called Let's Sing and Dance for Comic Relief where you had to sing and dance. And the stakes were very low. And I just could not tell bits of my body to do things. I was saying, if it's like, move your arm, I can do that. Move your arm and your leg at the same time, impossible. My body can't do it. I don't know how to program myself to do it. I thought what you guys did on that show was amazing.
Yeah. I never mastered that.
Do you ever have that nightmare thing where you wake up in your dreams, it's like, now, what do they always say? Welcome
dancing
to the floor.
Dancing the
Paso Doble.
Yeah, and you think, no, I'm not, no, I'm not.
Do you dream that dream?
Oh, I still have that, yeah, that fear.
Fridays.
Oh, the most terrifying experience, wasn't it? Because you'd get up there on Friday and it was your first time on the floor, doing it with the lights, hearing the music, and you'd think, I don't know the steps here, and I'm going to be doing this in front of the nation tomorrow.
Everyone had a little cry on a Friday.
Yeah. It was an emotional day.
Yeah. Fearsome
Friday.
We're
interrupting something here.
But we can't really get the moves out now. Do you know what I mean? Because you can't really get into the old ballroom hold on your own.
No.
Well, there are two of you.
Well, I mean, now you've said it. No,
go on, why not?
Shirley Ballas did always say that I had a really impressive frame. Yeah, that was about the only good thing that any of the judges ever said about me.
Oh, so good.
Okay, good. We're glad we sorted that out.
Thank you.
So, Molly, what is the key to radio then? What's the key?
I'm still learning, Tim. I mean, you have to just completely open up. And that's the thing that I think from the first show, Matt was like, just be honest, just say anything that you want to. I think being in a girl band, you learn to, you can't help but be quite guarded. But now you've literally just got to completely say it how it is.
Which is the show she's going to drive the desk, because we all want to tune in.
I don't know, but she's had her first lesson this week, and it wasn't too bad, right?
No, it went OK, actually.
Yeah. Yeah, we're not going to say when it is, but you'll know, you'll hear it.
Thanks, Matt. Thanks for that, yeah.
Molly, radio is about painting pictures.
Right.
A controller of radio once told me that. Okay. Tim, you're all right, but you're not painting enough pictures. Paint pictures with
your
words.
I'll try. I'll give it a go.
OK. All right, thanks, guys. Your show is on Fridays, Saturdays and Sundays between 1 to 4 on Radio 1. You'll be joining us in the kitchen a little bit later.
Indeed. In just a moment, all the signs point
to... It's Sunday Brunch Live. We're cooking with Molly and Matt. Before we cook, we've got something new and exciting to try. These are, Simon, called, as I search, these are called, Simon, biodegradable juice balls. And the juice company Press, that's it, are trialing these biodegradable and edible algae juice.
Mm.
It's I know you don't like eating stuff, but are you worried about texture as well? Or you
no,
just...
I can pop one of these balls in.
Okay. It is with the. This is. These have been made in the view to moving towards more and more sustainable packaging across the whole product range. The four flavors are Berry Dreams, Sunshine Crush, Green Goddess, and Blue Magic, and they're exclusively on sale in Selfridges for $2.95.
That's a brilliant idea because it stops the plastic waste, right? You
just put
this in.
So which one? I want to try that because it looks like an egg.
I want to try the Green Goddess. That looks like it might be.
What's this guy?
I don't know. Which one do you want to try, Molly?
We've
got them at the table if you want to try them as well.
Give it a go.
I think you just stick
it down in one.
Throw it in one. Ooh. Oh, my God. Is it good? Oh, my God,
Don't
Matt.
Bite into it. That's a tactic. Don't bite into it. My goodness me, that was desperate to come out, and it did.
Oh, my God.
I'm fine. But if you do it over a ramekin, you can sit
it's quite intense, isn't it?
That's nice.
But what are you going to do in the jungle next year?
I know.
When you bite into it.
See, isn't it?
It's quite a mouthful, right?
Quite nice.
Quite surprising, isn't it?
Quite refreshing. I'm worried because it's in
there. Liking that, Mom.
Yeah. Lily! Molly, what are you doing? Have you been into it yet?
Oh, my God! That is just not enjoyable!
Has it exploded yet?
It has, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And where are these available again?
I thought they were okay.
I really like it.
I like the flavour of it. And it's a good idea, I think, anything we do.
I like the sensation.
How is your cooking? Molly, you've never been that good at cooking, have you?
No, I'm a terrible cook. Terrible, terrible. Mm. I try. I actually would send Simon pictures of sea bass on Strictly to try and get a few tips, because that's the only thing I can try and, like, whack it on the frying pan. And it's quite quick, isn't it?
Yeah.
So, yeah, I try and cook a bit of sea bass.
So you just have him, every time you cook, you just get him on the
phone. I send him a picture.
Because I do as well.
Yeah, give me a little five-star
If you
rating.
Want his number, I'll put it on Twitter later. Do you cook?
A little bit. A roast dinner, I'm good with a roast dinner. Very particular about a roast potato. I like them to be crunchy on the outside, fluffy on the inside. I can nail those every time. I'm a bit of a baker as well. I make a mean chocolate roulade.
But you only eat beige and brown food.
Yeah, I mean, both of those fall into those sorts of categories, so yes. Yeah.
So you don't eat vegetables?
No, I do eat vegetables. I love a bit of broccoli. I love roasted veg, so like some chopped and roasted peppers, things like that. Bit of sweet potato, those sorts of things. Basically, if I can put it on a baking tray, slide it into an oven, leave it for half an hour and then come back to it, I'm keen. Which with a roast dinner, you sort of can.
OK. All right. What are we making now?
We're going to do, shredded beef on toast. So we've got some beef cheeks, we've got some bacon, we've got some thyme, some celery, some carrots, some onions, some garlic, some tomato puree, some peppercorns. Then we've got stock, we've got red wine, we've got Madeira, and we've got some pork. And this is just a really long, slow cook. I mean, I'm putting on toast, you put it with anything. You could have it with mashed potato, you could have it with roast potatoes, will be delicious. But the first thing you need to do is get the toast on the go. So, Matt, what I need you to do...
I like that you feel like I'm qualified only to make toast, and you have to hit that bang on.
Well, I kind of, you know, I went on the basis of kind of your discussion with my daughter yesterday, as to kind of, you know, your lack of...
And you've even started it for me.
No. I mean, two slices, I know.
I was going to tell you, I think I can do this, guys.
And for anyone who's just tuned in, they won't understand why he's been sitting talking to your daughter. So, basically, your daughter was listening. You were talking about coming on the show, and she phoned in to stick up for you.
And we had a lovely chat. Well, not to stick up
for me. She phoned in to stick up for me.
Yeah.
She phoned and agreed with him.
Mm. Ah.
Because Matt was querying as to kind of what should he talk about. And
yeah.
Basically, Flo said, me, Liverpool Football Club, or food, and don't make eye contact if he doesn't like the
yeah.
food.
Also, she said we should talk about you, that one of your favourite topics is yourself, Simon.
So is that what she said things, about yeah. you?
Those were the three things. Mm. Not my words, the words of Flo.
Yeah. That's not very nice.
I know. Daughters, but to be honest with you, she's not my favourite daughter anymore.
Thank you.
Molly is my surrogate daughter.
I am. Sorry, Flo. Sorry.
Okay.
I know, surrogate daughter.
Yeah, how many? Well, let's test your knowledge on Molly. How many times has Molly come on the show, do you think?
This is her fifth time.
Fifth time. Is it?
Is it?
I don't know.
You said that with such confidence.
About it, and
you work with her on Strictly. Did you know that she has a phobia of holding small things?
No.
True fact.
Is this true?
This sounds so weird. Right, you know, like tiny things. For example, a garden pea on its own.
A fivepence piece.
A fivepence piece. I don't like holding a single one on its own. If it's a cluster, fine.
Never offer her a mint.
Yeah, a tiny mint is a bit creepy to me.
That was exactly
I know.
Why?
I think I feel like it's a bit dirty. Like, where's it been? It's so small.
Simon?
Tic-tac is too small, yeah.
But even if it's been in, you've just bought a fresh bag of box of Tic-Tacs.
Then
you,
I would.
Do you still think
they're
dirty?
I'd get out a few at once.
If
I know it
just,
sounds
if
stupid.
You could just look at Lily's face there, that's all our viewers. All our viewers are sitting there going,
this, Molly.
What is going on?
No, I'm sorry, it's really weird. It's just that I find it really creepy.
How did you find this out? You found this out, didn't you?
I found this out, and we were going to do something else on the show, and I offered Molly a mint, and she said, no, I don't like holding small things. and I thought, well, that's the radio show now. So we did test her out with holding lots of small things, and true to form, she doesn't like holding them.
What's the cut-off point, Mark? What point are you? Is it acceptable?
Yeah. What's the biggest thing you? What's the smallest thing you will hold?
Stop it!
I'm sorry.
He spent too much on the side.
Oh God.
What is it?
A twopence piece, fine.
For the one p, out of the question.
Is fine as well. A bit thicker, isn't
weighty,
it?
Weighty, isn't it?
Weighty. It's actually, that's the weight of it. It's a big thing. The weight of it is a big thing. If it's really light, no.
Kidney bean?
That's okay.
Okay.
Yeah, I can deal with a kidney bean.
Kidney bean, but a pea, not so good.
A garden pea, if it's left on the counter, I just wipe it off rather than pick it up.
Is this why the Saturday split up?
Right, we are not going to remotely show how this is cooked. I've sealed off the beef cheeks. In here we have bacon, we have carrot, we then have the celery, that'll do you, Mol.
Sorry, and
then we
I'm have, going slow here.
Then we have, oh, these are small pieces, Mol.
I'm sorry.
Here goes the onion. You cook that out for 7-8 minutes until it's nice and soft.
Should I keep going here? Am I done?
What? Oh, you're done.
Oh, I'm done.
Yeah. We've run out of time. Then what we do, we put in tomato puree, cook that out for 7-8 minutes or so. Time, the peppercorns, the garlic goes in, a bit of thyme goes into there. Our toast is done. That does that. Then what we do, we stick all of our liquids in there, stock, red wine, Madeira and port. So you've got lovely big, deep flavours in there. You bring that up to the boil. Once that comes up to the boil, we put the cheeks back into the pan and you cook those out for minimum 2.5 hours. They're done when you can break them down with a spoon. That's kind of how far they have to go.
What's the optimum then? 2.5 is the minimum?
2.5 would be your minimum.
Four?
I'd take five.
4 to 5, 5. Okay.
I genuinely would have a nice 5-hour cook, because then what happens is you get this delicious mix. As I say, you know, you can serve this with anything. Mashed potato, chips, roast potato. A little bit of vinegar at the end gives us some nice acidity into that. And then the test, can we break this down with a spoon? Yes, we can. So you get all this lovely
gelatinous, delicious beef sits like that. And that is just heavenly. Now, what you can do if you want this to make it even richer, you could scoop the cheeks out at this point, boil down that sauce so it becomes really thick and syrupy and gravy-like. But for our point of view, i.e. we've run out of time, then it's absolutely fine. So we're going to serve it simply lobbed on. Actually, let's use our fresh ones. Lobbed on our beautiful bits of toast that go on to there. And you can see ours is starting to break down beautifully, but the more you cook it, the more it breaks down. You get all this luscious gravy onto there, and that little bit of vinegar at the end gives some additional flavour into it. And then on the top, for yet more deliciousness, two things. We shave some Manchego cheese on there, which is rich and delicious. And we've put vinegar in there to counteract that and just give some more depth of flavour. Literally, a tiny little drizzle of honey over the top.
Honey?
Is just heavenly. Listen, this sounded like a good idea when I was drunk in the pub. But the Manchego and the honey, together with the beef, which you got a bit of vinegar in, is heavenly.
Yum.
There we go, go for it. Right. That beef is pretty hot in terms of
the rocket
temperature.
Is that just decor? Rocket. This. Is that just decoration?
That is. The rocket is, for...
Oh, that's so good.
Observation.
The whole thing. The whole thing.
It's for a time when you have more time.
Is it big enough?
It's great.
Fine, OK.
Yum.
How delicious is that?
So good.
Try this.
Long, deep, slow cook.
Really lovely.
And a little bit of vinegar at the end just gives it a lift. Nice.
He didn't have eye contact with you. He didn't have eye contact.
The honey is a good touch.
The honey's a good
touch. Thank you. Thank you, Matt. Thank you, Molly. I would say goodbye to you now, Matt, as you're dashing off
to work. I've got to go to the radio.
Yeah, well, Flo will be ringing you later. Full season of Christmas, head to the website, townhall.com/SundayBrunch after the break. We chat to Tony and his drinky poos time.
Don't cut it too small. Molly's over there.
Okay.
How did that. Molly, what is wrong with you?
We haven't got long enough for that.
What do you do about buttons?
Oh, don't.
Buttons are fine, actually. The thickness is good.
Someone's tweeted in to say, do you ever wear earrings and how do you...
I don't wear earrings.
Oh.
Because of
that. An earring is a nightmare for me. Like a tiny stud, no.
Isn't it more the backs of the earrings?
The backs, oh, yes. Yeah, see, you get that, right? Yeah. You get it.
Not really, but I can...
Whatever, Lily,
That's beautiful. That's glorious. So what we do, so we get all of our rhubarb and then zest the orange over the top, cut the orange in half, squeeze
the juice. Molly, I feel like we're being really mean, but you've got to understand how it's kind of... it's a bit weird. They take the mickey out of me because I'm phobic to smells and I don't like looking at patterns and leopards and things.
It's fine.
I'm thinking Molly seems quite normal. I've worked with you for 11 years, Tim.
Oh, yeah.
Says the man who's quite obsessed with fonts today. Yeah. Maybe I've got no room
fonts
to talk.
Fonts and bins.
To them.